Hello, you're on Public Spot. I'm George. Welcome to another episode on this series, Infrastructure Code for Event-Driven System in AWS. And today, I'll be writing Terraform code that will build my Docker images and persist these images into ECR, which is a Docker repository in AWS. And so if this episode and this channel lines up with your interests, click the subscribe button and join me in this journey of learning by doing. So, let's start coding. So as I always do before starting work, I'll pull down any changes to my remote repository in my local repository. So I'm going to run and then create a new branch for all my changes. And then in the root of my local repository, I'll create a new directory called infrastructure. And then I'll cd into this new directory and run my script to create my baseline Terraform code. So now if I open my Explorer, expand my infrastructure folder, and I have all my base Terraform config files in there. And then I'll go ahead and open my main.tf. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna list down all the first set of changes that I'll implement today. So I've got three items that I need to accomplish today. So let me just say that. The first thing that I need to set up is building my Docker images and storing them in a Docker image repository in AWS called ECR. So I have two separate Docker images in my project repository, the backend and the worker. So I need to set up two separate image repositories in ECR. And then I need to build my Docker images and push them into these repositories, which means I'll be building my Docker images as part of my Terraform code. And for this to be possible, I need to update my backend.tf for the appropriate Docker provider setting. So let me open my backend.tf. And then inside my providers.tf, I'll add the appropriate provider block. Inside this provider block, I need to set a configuration property called registry auth, which is going to allow my Docker provider connectivity with my AWS ECR. So the address field will need to point to my AWS ECR URL. So what I'll do is pull the value up from a local parameter. And then I'll head over to my locals.tf and define that local parameter. This AWS ECR URL starts with the AWS account ID, and it also needs a reference to the AWS region where the resource is. I have an existing variable definition for region, so I can go ahead and update that. I need to pull the appropriate account ID. So what I need to do is define a data reference to the AWS caller identity resource inside my data.tf. So let me open my data.tf. Having set this data reference, I can then go back to my locals.tf and have a reference to the account ID associated to that data reference. And then back to my providers.tf. I need to set the username and password properties that would allow me to log into AWS ECR and be able to push my Docker images. So what I need to do is define another set of data reference, this time for AWS ECR authorization token inside my data.tf. And then go back to my providers.tf to set the username and password based off what the properties are of this data reference. And now I can move to the next set of changes to build my Docker images. So let me go back to my main.tf. So I've finished that first task. So let me go ahead and remove the to-do mark. And then move to the next item. So first, I'm going to create the Docker registry image resource for my backend service. So what I've set in this block are name and build properties. This build property right here will tell the resource where to look for the Docker context, which in my case is the application directory, which is right here. And the Docker file tells Terraform to use the backend Docker file available in the Docker context, which in this case will be this file right here. And then for the name property, I will use the repository URL property of my AWS ECR resource definition, and then append the string latest at the end. So what I'm going to do is, and that's the Docker registry image for my backend service. So let's close my Explorer. Now I need to set up the same thing for my worker service. So all I have to do is duplicate this block, change the name to worker. So if I look at this code now, I notice that there are repetitions in the code. And so I can refactor this now and minimize the repetition. So what I'll do is to introduce a new variable to hold the list of repository names that I want to set. So I'm going to go to my variables.tl and then define a new variable. Now that I've got the variable set, I can then update the creation of my ECR repository by going through each element in this variable. So let me go back to my main.tl. Scroll up to the creation of the ECR repository. And then I'm going to change this. And now I can get rid of this. I can also use the same variable when I'm creating my Docker registry images. So what I'm going to do is, and then I can also get rid of this block. And now I have less code than before, and it's a lot easier to read. The first two steps are done, so let me get rid of the to-do markers of the second one as well. So this third task is what I've actually done in my providers.tl. This is where I've defined a valid AWS ECR URL and also derived a username and password that I can use to be able to log into ECR from within Terraform. So if I go back to main.tf, this last task is also done. And now I can start validating my code. And because I'm using a Docker provider, I need to make sure that I have Docker running on my machine. So to verify this, I'll open my terminal. And then I can simply run Docker version. So that looks good. Now I can go ahead and validate my Terraform code. So I'm getting that old issue that I've been facing several times, which is resolved by setting up Terraform binary using ASDF command. So I'm just going to go back to the root of my repository and then run ASDF local. And then go back to the infrastructure directory and then run my validation again. So I've got some spelling errors in here. So let me go to my backend.tf, line 2, and fix that. And then run my validation again. And then this time it's an incorrect property name that needs to be updated. So it says inside providers.tf. And then we just need to fix that and add the underscore. All my configuration files are clean this time, so let me go ahead and commit my changes to my local branch on my local repository. Now, I want to stand up the ECR resources and verify that the images are created successfully and persisted inside ECR. But before I proceed, I need to update my backend.tf so that my Terraform state files are going to be stored in Terraform Cloud. So let me head to my backend.tf, and then in here, I'll set up the backend remote configuration for my backend.tf. And because I'll be running this against actual AWS services, I need to export my AWS profile. So let me go back to my terminal. And then I need to make sure that I have the appropriate tf vars defined. My automated Terraform script creator actually creates a main.tf vars in here. So I'm going to use this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the region variable in here and set it to AP Southeast 2. And then I need to export the TF workspace environment variable and set it to main. And then I'm going to start running Terraform init. So my Terraform init complains about a non-existent workspace, so I have to create that. So now that my workspace is created, I can go ahead and run my Terraform plan. So I've got an error, and that's an easy fix. It's just missing the closing quotes. So I'm getting a new set of errors in here. So let me expand this terminal so we can see the whole set of error messages. I think this is because I need to change the execution mode on my workspace in Terraform Cloud and make sure that it's set to local instead of remote. So let me switch to my browser and then search for that workspace, event-driven system infrastructure. So this is the one. And then go to settings, general, and then this execution mode section in here needs to be changed to local, and then save settings. Now if I go back to my VS Code, I'm gonna try to run plan again and see if it works. So now let me go ahead and run my Terraform apply to stand up the infrastructure. completed successfully, let me head over to my web console and verify that the images are pushed to ECR. And then head over to ECR. And then my two repositories are created. Let's open each one. So the image is there. Let's check worker. And then the image is there as well. And that's it for today. Stay tuned for another set of infrastructure code in Terraform as I slowly build up the underlying infrastructure for my simple event-driven system. In the meantime, let me know your thoughts in the comments below and send me some likes if you find this useful. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like my content and help me spread the word about this channel. Until next time, keep learning and stay safe.